Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel, and today I will be talking about financial planning. And the reason why I have created our YouTube channel is the main purpose is education about financial planning and how investments are so simple and you can do it yourself. As soon as you hear this particular word, you will actually be looking for a financial planner and how you can actually plan your expenses in, from your income, etc. So I'm going to just simplify this for you in few steps here. And as soon as you get a job, if you are in the early 20s or mid 20s, you have to keep some things in mind. If you are past that particular stage, then you go to 30s and mid 30s, etc., and so on. But what happens is you would actually be missing out this important part, all mainly because you may not have found a financial planner, or you might be too lazy to find a good one. Where should I find, and things like that. So right now, at this time of the year in 2018, we have a small problem called information overload. And I'm going to just simplify it for you so that it will be helpful for all you guys. And if you have any questions or clarifications, you can always ask me anytime. So let's begin. So if you are thinking about financial planning, this is very, very important, because of the medical expenses, emergency expenses, any kind of emergency expenses. So if you are in the mid 20s, or as soon as you get a job, I would suggest to invest in tax saving instruments. So in mutual funds, there's only one category of mutual funds which are actually available for tax savings. These are ELSS funds, equity linked savings schemes. And just to help you understand it better, these have a locking period of 3 years. This is actually the lowest locking period among all tax saving instruments under section 80C. So this section is provided by Government of India to have tax savings, and ELSS funds are actually very good funds for saving and also for tax savings, and also to accumulate your retirement corpus. Now you might ask me that this has a locking period of 3 years. There are other tax saving instruments which has a locking period of 5 years and more. So these are the lowest locking period which you have, and your money is, your wealth is also growing in this case. So you're actually saving your taxes here, and also your amount is keep on growing over the period. So this is a perfect savings for your retirement corpus. So once you retire, you will have it's like a pension, and it will keep on growing how the stock markets work. So if you do not know how ELSS funds work, you can watch my other videos where I have actually explained ELSS funds, and also ELSS versus ULIPs, unit linked funds. So this is my suggestion whenever you are actually beginning your financial planning. So that's very important, that there are other instruments like fixed deposits which have a locking period of 5 years and more, but this is taxable, and the interest what you earn from FDs is completely taxable, so you have to be very careful. For equity linked savings, the interest is not taxable, and till 1 lakh rupees, and any kind of interest which you earn more than 1 lakh rupees, that is taxable. 10% flat tax, long-term capital gain tax as of now, but that also you have a workaround from which you can save that too. So as I told you, I would not suggest this because FDs are always taxable. So I'm just going to remove this from here, so that should not be part of your financial planning. So I personally don't consider FDs as a great investment plan, because the returns are completely taxable. That also has a locking period of 3 years, 5 years, but any FD which has a locking period of 5 years is eligible for tax deduction under 80C. So this is very, very important. So when you are in a job, every month a small amount going as an SIP, systematic investment plan, would be much less worrisome than you paying a huge amount of tax or anything like that. So mutual funds, equity mutual funds, are another financial instruments which I would say to invest it. So as soon as you, if you are a beginner, if you have just joined a company, these are the two mandatory financial investments which you should make. So in equity mutual funds, I think if you are in the age group of early 20s or mid 20s, then I would say small or mid cap. If you do not know what are small or mid caps, then please watch my other videos where I have explained what are equity mutual funds, what are small and mid caps, to have a better understanding. This video is more about financial planning and what kind of instruments you can actually invest on it. So these are the two mandatory financial planning you have to do it to ensure that you actually have some kind of savings, and also your savings income is growing. Now here I would like to talk about bank interests. This is not part of this financial planning, but I would like to know, I would like to educate how bank interests are taxed. So many people don't know that bank interest, the interest what you receive from bank is very low. Right now it is 3.5%. Some banks do provide you higher rate of interest, however that is taxable as per your slab, as per your income tax slab. So the as you know, up to 2.5 lakhs there is no tax, and above 2.5 lakhs to 5 lakhs, it's 5%, 5 to 10 lakhs, it's 20% taxes, and above 10 lakhs, it's 30%. So if you are in the highest tax slab, you would actually be, your bank interest will be taxable at this percentage, above 10,000 rupees. So that's how bank interests are taxed. So as you know that if you are actually in the highest tax bracket, there is no point in keeping your money in your bank interest, even though that is completely liquid. But that is the same case with equity mutual funds or other mutual funds. So this video is not to confuse you about the different plans, but I just want to say that, you know, if you are having savings, then it is better to put it in equity mutual funds. ELSS will still be locked in for 3 years, but you can put it somewhere here, or liquid funds. There is something called liquid mutual funds, and you can keep in these instruments instead of banks, but some amount you still have to keep it in bank for liquidity. Now at this point of time, there are a lot of liquid funds from Reliance and some other mutual fund houses where they give you a card to, like a debit card or an ATM card, from which you can actually withdraw money anytime. So you have to keep that in mind when you are making a financial planning. So other than these things, this would be your savings, and this would be for tax savings. Other than that, you should have actually a goal in mind. You should have a goal. For example, retirement. If you are married, you would have children's expenses, education, or their marriage. So you cannot ignore these facts that education will happen after 10 years, or my child's marriage will happen after 10 or 20 years, so I don't need to do anything, I'll figure out something. there is no way of figuring it out if you do not plan these things in advance. And a small part of your salary, if it is going to this, this and this, it will be a huge investment to your own wealth. Please do remember that bank interest will not accumulate over a period of time. If you have not watched my video on inflation, which is growing at 6 to 8% every year, your bank interest is giving you 3.5% every year, and the salary hike, whatever it is, your expenses will keep on growing. This bank interest will never beat this, and the bank interests are also reducing from time to time. So that is not the, but equity mutual funds, they keep on growing based on stock markets and the companies and the economy of a particular country. So there are a lot of funds available from which you can decide which ones to invest, etc. But this is generally, you should have a tax savings equity and a mutual fund, which is even if it is a small amount like 500 rupees or even 100 rupees, Reliance mutual funds actually give you to invest from starting from 100 rupees. You can actually skip a pizza for 1 month and actually invest in one mutual fund, and that's exactly, you can keep on accumulating your wealth. So these, the third point here is you have to need to identify a goal, and you have to start investing for one of these or all of these together with the accumulating by investing small amounts. For example, you put 500 here, 500 here and 500 here. What will happen is by next year, after 1 year, you can probably increase this amount. What happens is the power of compounding will come into effect, and over a long period of time, say 10 years or 20 years, your investment will keep on growing. So this is very important. As soon as you start a job, these are the three major investments you should consider. As I told you, which funds you should invest is another topic. I will have to come up with another video to tell you how to identify a good equity mutual fund or a small cap or a mid cap, etc. But these three things are very, very important when you start doing your financial planning. So hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions or clarifications on this topic, please feel free to write me on my Facebook page, or also you can comment me on the description below, and I'll be happy to answer them. So my Facebook page link is available on the description, so you can go to my Facebook page and inbox me there. I'll be happy to answer any kind of queries you have. I also write a lot on the Q&A platform Quora website, and so you can also contact me there if you have any questions. So thank you, and I will see you again on my next video.